we understood the concept of comparative analysis. There will be two columns. One will be change in amount, other will be change in percentage. And we did also now it will not lag. I have shifted the server now, and today I'm more happy. Almost 60 students is attending the session. Very good. Keep this kind of spirit. Now let us see yesterday's question which we were dealing with. Hereby we have seen that we need to do changes, of course, which is required. And the basics of comparative analysis is change in amount divided by base year amount into 100. So we have seen in the question number 15, page number 33 of the textbook. Sales for 2 years, 10 lakh, 8 lakhs were given. We have seen the difference in absolute form, that is in rupees form, as well as changes in percentage form. If someone has not taken, kindly take it and then update me. Then we'll go for the same questions balance sheet also. For the same question, they have asked balance sheet as well. It's done. This question we were dealing yesterday. So don't, right now it is revenue statement. Now it will be comparative revenue statement or common size revenue statement. Or subsequently we are going to learn trend analysis, etc., etc. Similarly here also you see I have changed and I have mentioned it as comparative balance sheet. It's done. Okay. Thank you, Samiksha. Now let us go for the same questions balance sheet, page number 33. So this was the question which we were dealing yesterday. Okay, this is the financial statement of Vaibhav Limited. Prepare comparative financial statement in vertical form. So we did first the profit and loss statement and the answer is there with you all. Now today we are going to do with balance sheet also. The details are given in 2013 and 14. I required your assistance. Kindly get me these details, equity, preference, general tax payable C, equity share capital, where it will come? Equity share capital, where it will come?
Shareholder fund.
Absolutely right. Preference share capital.
Shareholder fund.
Absolutely right. General reserve.
Reserve surplus.
Very good.
Surplus.
Other student also other than Aryan can participate. Tax payable. Tax payable. Tax payable. Current liability quick. Thank you, Shruti, for the right answer. Creditors. Creditors.
Current asset.
Current liabilities quick.
Yes, sorry. And
liability side by asset kaise dikhega? Thank you, Gajanan, for the right answer. Mommy. Then 17% debenture.
Long-term
liability.
Yes. So you must be knowing now everything is based on the vertical statement what we have learned earlier. Then subsequent application is required. Common size, taking sales or total fund employed as a 100 and calculating their percentage. In comparative, we are just segregating what is the changes in amount, how it is increasing or decreasing. Same way changes in percentage, whether plus or minus, so on and so forth. Land.
Fixed asset,
tangible. Factory, plant and building.
Fixed asset, tangible.
Stock. Stock.
Rossi, quick asset.
Wrong answer. Current asset, quick. Non-quick. Debtors.
Current asset, quick asset.
Absolutely right, Pranya. And cash.
Current asset.
Quick. So with this, you have to assist me. I will prepare your vertical statement for the same question. So tell me your equity share capital, preference share capital. SR value is moving. You'll get different answers. Yeah, how much is equity share capital in 2013?
4 lakh.
4 lakh and 4 lakh. So same way you have to assist me with the answer. 4 lakh. 2. Preference share capital?
3 lakh.
And in 2014?
3 lakh. Mommy.
Then?
General reserve, 2 lakh.
General reserve we have. How much
two
it
lakh.
Is?
2 lakh.
2 lakh.
Yes, sir.
And in 2014, others kindly solve also
two,
along with me.
Yes, 2,45,000.
2,45,000.
Yes.
Thank you. 2,45,000. Any other reserve we have?
No, sir.
Only one reserve we have. So let's remove these two items. We neither have any fictitious asset.
Yes, sir, we don't have.
So, can we write what is the shareholder's fund? It is 9 lakh. And it is 9,45,000. In borrowed fund, we have only debenture, and that too also 17% debenture. Making sense?
Yes, sir.
How much it is?
1 lakh.
In both the year, we have 1 lakh?
1,15,000. 50,000. 1 lakh. 50,000.
So what is total? This is only the total borrowed fund. Delete this. So how much will be the total fund employed? 10 lakh. And it is 10,95,000. Similarly, in fixed asset, we don't have any intangible item.
Yes, sir, we don't have.
We have only tangible asset, land and buildings, plant and machinery, and there is no depreciation either. What is the value of land and building?
2 lakh.
How much?
2 lakh.
2 lakh?
Yes, sir.
Okay, 2 lakh and 2,40,000. Plant and machinery?
6 lakh. And 5,40,000.
6 lakh. 5,40,000.
We also have cash and debtors.
The investment is not there, no? Working capital. What we have, cash and debtors.
Yes, sir.
How much it is?
Debtors 2 lakh and 3 lakh.
Cash.
Cash 1 lakh and 1,40,000.
1 lakh. and
140,000. Debtors 2 lakh and 3 lakh.
And 3 lakh in non quick current asset, we have only the stock.
Yes, sir.
We don't have
2 lakh and 3 lakh. No, stock is 2 lakh and 3 lakh.
So what is the total current asset? Okay, first we have to write total fixed asset also, which is 8 lakh. And 7 lakh. Yes. This is my A. Fixed asset 1, and now we are getting current asset and current liability, then we will get 2. So current asset 5 lakh, $7,40,000. Current liability, we have only 2 things, creditors, yes, and tax.
Tax payable.
Rest all is not there. Not a provision for tax, it is income tax liability. Sorry, tax payable. How much it is then?
2 lakh.
Sorry?
2 lakh. Creditors 2 lakh and
2 lakhs and
2,75,000.
Tax payable
1 lakh
and
1,50,000.
So what is total current asset? Current liability. How much you are getting? Here it is 3 lakhs. Here it is 4,25,000. So now what is working capital? Current asset minus A minus B.
2 lakh.
Yes, 2 lakh.
3,15,000.
3 lakh?
15,000.
So we got working capital. So total application of fund will be 1, fixed asset, 2, working capital. So 1 plus 2, 3 नहीं है, 1 plus 2.
10 lakh.
10 lakh.
10,95,000.
10 lakh.
95,000.
So is it telling? Yes. So my answers are right. And all I got it from the concept of vertical statement. Yes or no? Till here, nothing we have learned new. Now we'll be learning as comparative analysis. Very simple. Chalo, one by one. What is the change in amount? Nothing. Don't write zero, huh? Don't write zero. Here also nothing. Here also nothing. Here we have how much? 45,000. So change in percentage will be how much? 45,000 divided by 2 lakh into 100. 22.5%. Thank you, Shruti. Then again 45,000. Here it is 50,000. It will be 50%. Is 95,000. No, it will be 50%. Just check Deepesh, Harsh. 50,000 divided by 1 lakh into 100. It will be 50%. Now it is 95,000 divided by 10 lakh. 9.5%. So my common size is ready. Similarly here, 40,000. Okay. And then 40 divided by 2 lakh into 100. How much? 20%. Oh, I got the answer from the student. Thank you, entire division of C. Now everyone is participating. I'm very happy. Now this time it is negative. Negative 60,000. So negative 10%. Then minus 20,000. Again minus 2.5. Wow. Very nice. Now student is participating effectively. Again 40,000. One lakh. Again 1 lakh. Again 50%. 2,40,000. How much it is? 2,40,000 divided 48%. Very nice. Quickly, less than 1 minute left. Here it is 75,000. How much it is? 75 divided by 37.5. 50,000. 50%. 1,25,000. फास्ट लिखो, कभी भी खत्म हो सकता है अपना टाइम. 1,25,000. हाउ मच इट इज? 1,41,670.